realized binary code actually originated in the 1600s. There are really super basic binary codes that most people skip over. For instance, Morse code is binary code. Braille is also a binary code. So any way you can use two symbols to transfer tons of information, that came from here. So what role do these two machines play? All right.
Yeah.
Picture in your mind, 1850, there is no computing, there is no electricity. We can't take these incredible drawings and then just scan them in and have the machines run. You have to figure out how do you translate a drawing to a pattern that a machine can follow. So that's what had to happen first. That piece of paper is broken down into smaller and smaller and smaller and smaller squares until they're about half the size of your average graph paper square. He would start with the first square in the upper right left-hand corner. If there was color in that square, he poked a hole in this part. If there was no color, he skipped it and went to the next square, leaving a blank. Color, poke a hole. No color, leave a blank. And he would keep working his way across the paper and punching holes in the cards down here. Eventually, then all those cards are laced together into one long pattern like this. So what you actually see here is the pattern for that bedspread that's behind us. So very, very simple. All of you computer science people, how do we send a man to the moon? Using an IBM computer that was controlled by punch cards that had holes poked in them on and off. And guess where that technology came from? Right here.